Hello guys, welcome to Promise Bale Channel. In this channel, we educate upcoming music producers, especially Cubase users, on how to utilize their Cubase. And I have been receiving some requests how to multi-track using our Soundcard, Focusrite Soundcard, it can be Behringer Soundcard, and any kind of Soundcard that you have. Currently, if you have a Soundcard that is more than 3 inputs to 4 inputs and you want to record at the same time and you are finding it difficult to route the settings, I will show you quickly on Cubase how to make that happen in just 2 minutes. So without wasting time, if you are an existing subscriber, thank you for coming back to our channel. And if you are a new subscriber, thank you. After watching this video, if it's helpful to you, please click the subscribe button and put on the notification bell so that we can alert you on a new video when it is released. Let's dive right into this tutorial.
So I'm on Cubase. You can do this on any Cubase that you have currently. As you can see on the other video is my Soundcard and it is 18i20. That means I have 18 inputs and 20 outputs. If you divide that, it's going to be 8 inputs and 10 outputs. Now the way our Focusrite is designed is input 1, input 2. So it means on this input is left, input 2 will be right. Input 1 is left, input 2 is right. So how to route that quickly is very simple. You have 18 input and 20 output. But if you turn the back, or if you calculate the input, actually it will not be up to 18. As you can see, I'm using 2 output already. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now I have 2 at the front, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The first thing you do is go to studio. If you are on Cubase 11, 12, and 13, or if you are on Cubase 5, it may be setup. After clicking studio, you come over to studio setup and go to audio connections. Then you click this, your ASIO driver, and choose the sound card. For me, I'm using Focusrite. If you're using Behringer, you take that particular one. I will stay with my Focusrite sound card and press OK. The second step is you press F4 on your keyboard. When you press F4 on your keyboard, now if you are recording a bass guitar and a lead guitar, then you're recording a saxophone and a trumpet. Let's take it that way for a proper explanation. So because the sax and the trumpet is a wind instrument, you can add a bass and name this wind instrument and click OK. Click enter. Make sure it's on stereo, please. Click OK. Then create another bass and just add this music instrument
or whatever name you feel like giving it and press OK. So after doing that, if you look at this pole, you have input 1, input 2, input 3, input 4. If you look at this wind instrument on one stereo has two, which is why if you have a Focusrite Soundcard and they name it 2i4 or 4i4, it means 4 input and 4 output. The reason is because one input is stereo and one stereo contains two, input 1 and input 2, which is left and right. Left is input 1, right is input 2. Any Soundcard in the world is routed like that.
If you are using these two first input, this is input 1, which is this. This is input 2, which is this. So if you are recording just these two, you only need one bus. Let's say this wind instrument bus on top.
You only need this first bus, because if you're adding any audio track, you add the track and click the destination, which is left or right. So let's go. Now we intend to record 4 instruments. So we'll come here and add our audio track and make sure it is on mono. So we add 4 tracks. 4 tracks are added. Let me name this one guitar. I will name this one bass. So don't forget our sax, which is our wind instrument, and our trumpet.
Now that we have done that, the first thing I'm going to do, so let's assume this is our saxophone chord. Plug it into input 1. Don't forget input 1 is always the first. If you are routing wind on the first bus, make sure you are plugging your wind instrument on the first bus. So this is our saxophone. What we are going to do now, on our saxophone, we're going to click the saxophone, come over to our input routing, then click left because it is input 1. Click left. Now this is our trumpet chord. Plug this in to our sound card. Once that is plugged into the sound card, we come back to Cubase, click the track. This is our trumpet track. Click it, come over to your input routing, click it and put this on right. I hope you understand. That is 2. Then let's take this as our guitar chord. So my other inputs are at the back. Yours can be at the front like this. Doesn't matter. And don't forget, these are the knobs where you can adjust all the volumes. So I will plug this at the back. Please follow me closely. So this now that I just plugged in is our guitar.
So this will be on our instrument bus. We'll come back here to the Cubase, go to our input routing, and go to our instrument bus. and put this on left. I hope you understand, because it is three. If I'm putting this on the fourth input and I'm not using the third input, what I will do is I will come back to my input routing and carry this to right. That is the only way it can work. Now let's take this as our bass guitar chord. So we'll come over to our track bass, come over to our input routing, and under our instrument bus we'll put this one on right. If you have 20 instruments according to the input on the Soundcard, follow same process to create all, then you alight all of them so that the record button can be on all of them. Once the record button is on, the next you're going to do is press record and start playing all the instruments. You can see this is the microphone I'm talking, although there are no instruments here, but you can use that. This is just for this is just a tutorial. So I'm using the microphone and it's working. You can see it's working. Then this is the chord in my hand. If I tap the chord, you can see it's recording and the mic is talking at the same time. You can see the frequencies and the wave are different. So this is how to route your Soundcard to record multi-track. You are in the studio and you don't have a digital mixer. And also, you can use this in the live recording settings in the place of a digital mixer if you can. All you need to do is let all the input go through your Soundcard. If you have a Soundcard like this, then just pick the art where I'm touching this out here, send this to your mixer, and that is all. So thank you. I hope you understood. If you don't understand, please put your questions on the comment section and I will promise I will treat them one after the other. Just in case you are not so clear, please locate my other tutorial up there that talks about a full comprehensive work on the Cubase session. Thank you for joining me. I will see you again. God bless you. Bye for now.